Okay, the next step. Let's see, does that look good? Yeah, okay. One thing I forgot to mention about the devices so far is that I have all the manuals on the flash drives, and most of them also are booklets that you can look at. And I also cut out some of the images that are really useful, like the routing diagrams for the lexicon. And the instructions for the recorder are pretty complicated, so you should read them pretty carefully, because there's lots and lots of features that I couldn't begin to get into without taking a lot of time. And you're best off learning to use them by doing. So those manuals are on the flash drives. Now, the next thing I wanted to show you is some things. And most of these things are things I've never used in eon. This is so dusty, I had to clean it off. And this is so ancient. Radio Shack doesn't even exist anymore. And woo. What this is a sound level meter. It's battery operated. It's a battery in here. You can stick those tripods on here if you like from the handheld thing or the recorder tripod. They'll fit in there. And let's see, when you switch this, it's off. When you switch to battery, it'll check the battery level. And then you pick the range that you want. That's 120 dB. Very, very, very loud. Normally, you work your way down until you get the meter starting to move. So now, here at 70, okay, at 70 dB, it's starting to move. So that means the dial is saying at 70 dB, the zero on this meter is 70 dB. So right now, I'm talking at about a 70 dB level. The response is set for fast, so the meter shows immediately what my voice is doing. So you can see the peaks. And then if I do slow, then you see it's much more sluggish. And it kind of averages the signal together. So depending upon what you want to do, you need one or the other. And there's also an A weighting or a C weighting. And I've forgotten the technical terms and technical reasons, but I think one is generally for the fast signals and C is for the slow signal. Yeah. Okay, see, there's a big difference here. Now when I talk, let's see. No, zero, zero. La. La. Yeah, okay, the C is much more sensitive for some reason. And I don't remember the technical reason for A weighting or C weighting. You should read the manual. What this is for, though, is when you're doing field recordings, you want to be able to set the microphone levels pretty accurately. And, of course, the meters are there on the mics. But this is kind of nice because you can go all around the place and check things out and see what the maximum levels are and not get any surprises. So the general rule is you start with the highest level. 120 would blow your eardrums off. You typically will always be under 100 dB because these are pretty dangerous up there. And 90 dB is pretty darn loud. 80 dB, you can see here, I'm measuring minus 10 on 80 dB. So 80 minus 10 is 70 dB. And 70 dB is normally, you know, room level sounds. And now 60 dB, it's almost always peaking. Now, you don't want to go any lower than that because this is not a digital meter. This is an analog meter. If you go lower, it'll peg it and hit it, and it might bend the needle. That's why you always start with the highest and work your way down each time until you see a response. And then you want to kind of find out which one is the average zero, and say, okay, this is averaging around minus 4, set plus 70, that'd be 66 dB. So we know then what the volume level is in terms of decibels. And so that's useful to know. And these are pretty accurate, fairly directional. And there's also, well, there's a calibrator here if you really want to get technical and set it perfectly. And then there's an output that just takes this microphone here and puts it out here. So if you want, you can use this as another microphone, but I've never tried that, but you could. It's generally used for sending to recording instruments, like those meters on the strip of paper, like heartbeat or EEG meters, like that, you know, that measure stuff and set a permanent recording. Okay, so that's that. That's pretty simple. And I haven't used that in forever. But it's good for field recordings or new recording studios, auditoriums, classrooms, things like that. You get an idea of what the volume levels are like, and then you know how to set the meters so that you don't get any surprises. Okay. Next, we have some headphones. You've got to have a good pair of headphones because with speakers, you'll bother other people. If you start to develop sounds and you go looping things over and over again with the same stuff over and over and over to try to tweak things, it'll be really annoying for everybody else. So you'll want to just listen over headphones and not through the loudspeakers all the time. And this is a good set because it when you plug it in, it functions as a regular headphone. But there's a battery here, and the battery drives a noise-canceling circuit. There's a... Let's see, that's a little hard to... shouldn't have done that. Push it back in. There. When you turn on the noise canceller, there's a little microphone here that picks up, and this will turn green. And this uses the battery when this is on. And that battery doesn't last a whole long, I don't know, maybe 8 or 10 hours or so. So definitely want to turn this off. Don't leave it on. Or take the battery out. Anyway, when you turn this on, the microphone picks up the room noise and subtracts it from your ears. So when you listen, you hear really, really good close sound from the recording and no room sound. You could even just put these on unplugged and sit in a chair and read a book, and it'll cancel out all the room noises. So they're pretty nice. And we also have a microphone. This is a very good microphone. It's a professional quality. There's no on-off switch. It's just no batteries, nothing. These things can come apart, but I wouldn't take them apart. There's a built-in pop screen, a foam, so that it won't make... So it's generally used for voices, but you can use it for instruments as well, like your recorder. And it's a very good mic, pretty heavy. And you plug these things in, these mic cables, and they lock, and you're ready to go. Get into that in a few minutes. Okay, so, let me organize for a minute. The next thing I want to get in part two, I'm going to stop this recording now. We'll get into the next thing.